And then eventually, what happens here then?
Well, my entrance is down here. So I'm giving the bees a hint, this is where I want the brood area. And what I found was, what I did was I pushed the end national frame hard up against here, and they actually more or less abandon this bottom segment. Then you can just cut it off, and then you can just use it in here.
Oh, and then you just move it up. Yes. Yeah. Or, and then what, you put another follower board
precisely,
in.
Another follower board in. Or you find that they this end comb becomes more or less redundant, and you can just take it out. You can do it various ways. And then what I tend to do is I always put new bars in at the entrance. I use an end entrance. New bars in at the entrance end, and just all the bars get pushed that way, and then they get to harvested and be pulled out here. Or if they're dirty old bars like these, combs, like that one,
they will eventually
just get taken out.
Which I'll explain to you, I think, now.
Yeah, we are jumping around a lot, aren't we? I'm wondering if we're jumping around too much for people, or whether actually we need just to be helpful and split into two smaller groups.
So you put those two in between?
What I do, since Phil's now introduced the concept of spaces...
It's Paul's fault. He asked me a question.
My top bars, have you got one of your top bars, Phil?
Yeah.
This is old comb that's been lying around. I just put it in here so you can see various things on comb. Brood comb, storage comb, broken comb, comb with wax moth in it.
Is that wax moth?
That's why I put it there. Right. And that black stuff is wax moth poo. It's not mouse poo.
Oh.
Okay, it looks like mouse poo.
And it's up there as well.
And you've got pollen in this one, so we were showing people yesterday what pollen looks like when it had some honey put on top of it, goes all shiny.
That's some more wax moth.
Lots of wax. This was a greater wax moth. I had these actually stored in the house over the winter. And there, that's the sort of damage a wax moth can do.
How do you get rid of that?
You squash the wax moth.
Yes, okay.
And you'll see, get the wax moth get down between the top bars. Right, you were asking me about spacing on top bars. Two versions of the dowel system. Phil, we yesterday had a top bar without the dowels and just a groove down it. Not a groove, sorry, just a piece of wood, a ridge nailed to it. These, I've gone over to these this season, first of all, the dowels, because I had a lot of comb breakage last year. Right. Last year was a very good year for bees expanding very, very rapidly. By this time last year, I had one colony that had gone from here to here.
Yeah, we had that last year.
And it was 17 bars of brood, 13 bars of stores, no room. Didn't even have room for a follower board. I mean, it was just absolutely bursting. That's the one I put the supers on, and they just ignored the supers. That's when I realised you never take your follower boards out. You always need one at one end, one at the other end. Otherwise, you have no room to do anything.
No, exactly.
Right? And as Phil says, if you can, keep it with a gap, but you sometimes end up with no gap. But the comb collapsed. Comb was collapsing because they were running the hive very hot, because when they're making comb, they brought the temperature up to 40 degrees centigrade. Masses of nectar coming in, newly built comb, just slumping down into the hive. So, and it nearly always breaks like that. Okay? Below, somewhere, it doesn't break off up here, it breaks off somewhere down here. So that's the bit you need to reinforce, that's why I built those.
That's one of the big criticisms that, conventional beekeepers have of top bar.
And these are one third, one third, one third, so 125 mils.
What does the dowel...
125 mils in total pushed into there, so that's about 100 mils.
So the dowel is in effect trying to bridge this section from there to there.
You'll see in the hive when we go down there, they build around this, and as long as it's only about 6 mils, they will incorporate that into the cone. If it's much bigger than 6 mil dowel, they will tend to treat that as a box, and they won't build around the sides.
Right.
Even now, they tend to build that bit first and then build these bits afterwards. But you will see I've got combs there which have been built this year, and that's been fully integrated. It reinforces the top bit, and as Phil says, the centre of gravity is about there, so I've only got a relatively small amount of weight down below.
Okay.
If I've got a square box, would I make those...